गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीबडी। मुँ एम राजेश्वर राव श्री विवेकानंद विद्या मंदिर आचार्य हिसाब से कार्य कर आज 10th क्लास सॉलिटेयर रिपेयर पढ़े पढ़ी पुणी रिवाइज कर डाउट क्लियर पर सब रिवाइज करा ध्यान से शुण बुझ। तापूर्व मुझे पॉइंट विषय किसी कौच तार पोएट होते विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ। विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ होते जड़े नेचर कवि नेचुरल कवि से प्रकृति उपर आधारित तो अनेक गुड़िया कविता लिखिं से कविता गुड़ाक मध्य सॉलिटेयर रिपेयर गोटे अन्यतम। तो सॉलिटेयर रिपेयर गोटे अच्छी बहुत तरह बहुत जितने पोएम भितर सॉलिटेयर रिपेयर तरह गोटे अन्यतम भल पोएमटी से 7th April 1776 से जन्म हे डेट ऑफ बर्थ 7th April 1770 एंड डेथ इज April 23rd 1850। से अनेक पोएम लिखिंट तादे यहाँ गोटे अन्यतम से गोटे प्राकृतिक कवि कहते फॉर हिज पोएम बा पोएट्री इज वेरी स्पॉन्टेनियस पावरफुल फीलिंग्स अराइजिंग फ्रॉम इमोशंस रिकलेक्शन ऑफ ट्रैंक्विलिटी। ट्रैंक्विलिटी मीन्स प्रशांति ट्रैंक्विलिटी मीन्स प्रशांति हियर ही डिस्क्राइब्स द ट्रैंक्विलिटी ऑफ द पोएम द नेचर सो हियर इज वेरी स्पॉन्टेनियस पोएम दैट इज सॉलिटरी रिपेयर। दिस पोएम इज अबाउट Solitary is the story of the poet's walk in the highlands of the Scotland. Highlands of the Scotland where he heard the song of a solitary girl. Solitary means here lonely. Solitary means a lonely. A lonely girl. And the song impressed itself on his memory. It impressed by his memory. Everlasting beauty and sorrow are the two major themes of the poem. The two major parts are there. That is everlasting beauty and also sorrow. Beauty and sorrow both running on the simultaneously on the way. Gotta pass the beauty, gotta pass the sorrow. The beauty and sorrow running in a same process. They are running in a very same process. Okay. Here the theme is beauty and sorrow. The poem presents two things, the labor of the girl and her expression of the sorrow. Labor of the girl and expression of the sorrow. She is working and singing at the same time without being bothered about the surroundings. She is singing and working. She never bothered about it. Both are running simultaneously. She never bothered about it. She want to speak about that one. She is not bothered about the surroundings. The poet deeply impressed. Deeply impressed by the enchanting sweet voice of the girl. Enchanting sweet voice of the girl. The girl's song sees profound effect on the poet. Profound on the effect of the poet. The song remained a dear memory for the poet long afterwards. The poem is affected on the poet everlasting, long life. This is the introduction. Again, we will talk about the poem. First, I am reading stanza 1. Beyond her single in the field, yon solitary highlands lost, leaping and singing by herself, stop here or gently pass. Stop here, gently pass. Behold means poetic form of sea. Behold, poetic form of the sea, S-E-E-C, dekhiba. Yon means old use, over there. Yon means over there. Over there. Yon. Solitary, single by alone. Solitary means single by alone. Highlands, lives in the highland, island of Scotland. Scotland is a pahadi anchalo jeeda. Reaping, cutting grains. Reaping means cutting grains, grains, sasya. Gently, very slowly. Getting very slowly. These are the hard words. And behold her single notes. While passing through the highlands of the Scotland, when the poet passing on the island of the Scotland, the poet sees young girl reaping and singing alone. The girl is reaping and singing alone. Cottage. ଶସ୍ୟ କାଟିକିରି ଅମଳ କରୁଛି ଆମେ ଗୀତ ଗାଉଛି ହି ଟେଲ୍ସ ଦ ପାସର୍ସ ବାଇ ଟୁ ଷ୍ଟପ୍ ଦେୟାର ଟୁ ଏନ୍ଜୟ ଦ ମ୍ୟୁଜିକ୍ ଟୁ ଗୋ ଏବେ ସ୍ଲୋଲି ସିଙ୍ଗିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ସେପଟେ ସେମାନେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ବାଟେମାନେ ସେ କହୁଛି ସମସ୍ତେ ଠିଆ ହେବ ସ୍ଲୋରେ ଯାଉ ଏ ମୁଁ ଯେ ଗୀତ ଗାଉ ସେଠି ଶୁଣ ବ୍ୟୁଟିକି ଏନ୍ଜୟ କର ଏନ୍ଜୟ ଦ ମ୍ୟୁଜିକ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ୱେ ସ୍ଲୋଲି ୱିଦାଉଟ୍ ଡିଷ୍ଟର୍ବିଂ ହେଲ୍ ତାକୁ ଡିଷ୍ଟର୍ବ ନ କରିକି ଧୀରେ ଧୀରେ ଯାଇକିରି ଏ ଗୀତଟା ଶୁଣି ଏନ୍ଜୟ କର ବୋଲି ସେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଓକେ ବୁଝିପାରିଲା ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଆଫ୍ଟରନୁନ୍ରେ ଯାହା ଅଛି ବାକି ଆଉ ଥରେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିବା ଓକେ